Monstrums, the time is nigh. Under the red moons, the wicked and the defiant shall be punished. Ascend into this unbreaking night. Unsheathe your curse and smite the darkness.
Let's get this started.
I'd expect no less from all of you.
This bodes well for the future.
Treasure chest!
Treasure. I got this. Huh.
Scratches should be tended to. It's all yours. Be sure to follow the instructions. Be sure to follow.
Can I?
Must take better care of yourself.
I am very sorry, sir, but that one isn't for sale, I'm afraid. Isn't she just the loveliest thing you've ever seen? She's the pride and joy of this little shop. Her name is Anemona. She's been around ever since the Hundred Years' War. From Balduke, are you, dear? Glia was in a war with Britai, a region across the sea. It lasted 100 years. All Glians, especially those who live here in Balduke, know it well.
Mrs. Rijndael!
My, my. Oh, you're one of Pendleton's daughters, aren't you? That's right. Little Krisha, my goodness, how much you've grown. And we are all grateful for your service, Sir Knight.
Sure.
What can I do for all of you today?
Well, we heard that a thief broke into your store.
Oh my, you came because you were worried about us?
Yes. Is there anything we could do to help?
Thank you very much, Krisha. Rodario is just about to take a break. Since you're all here, why don't we enjoy some tea while we talk?
And that's how the statue of the saint was stolen.
Saint? You mean Saint Rose Vita? Saint Rose Vita was a hero from the Hundred Years' War. Every Glian knows about her. She was only the daughter of a farmer, but ended up leading an army against Britai.
That's right. The stolen statue was made during the Hundred Years' War. Rodario had only recently purchased it not more than a week ago.
Oh yeah? Is it worth a lot?
Absolutely. And rightfully so. Though it pains us to have something of ours stolen, it's more upsetting that something made in Saint Rosvita's image is the object of greed.
That's awful.
About that, the culprits left a note.
Is it okay if we take a look?
By all means.
What is this?
This has got to be a joke. A prank by some punk-ass kids.
That's what we thought. But there were witnesses who said they saw the Monstrums. Similar notes were left in other shops, so many believe the Monstrums are to blame.
Oh no.
But there is something strange about all of this. Well, I can't say that for sure, but how do I put it? Their methods were surprisingly crude.
Yes, the lock on the door seemed to have been forcibly opened.
The hawk and the white cat are said to have remarkable powers. Isn't that right? If so, then these methods would be uncharacteristically unremarkable.
That's true. Have you reported this to the garrison?
Yes, naturally. But they're already very busy with the many other Monstrum complaints.
But that was why the Hieroglyph Knight sent you, was it not?
I'm grateful that our precious Anemona is safe at least. And it gives me comfort knowing that little Krisha came to make sure we're all right.
Yes, and from what I hear from your father, you left Pendleton to start your own business.
It's a long story. I'm sorry. I should have told everyone about it.
There's no need to apologize, dear.
We knew it was only a matter of time before you seized your own future. Ever since you were a little girl.
Huh?
You're stronger than you look, and you always keep your customers' best interests in mind. To be frank, we were worried knowing that you and your father don't see eye to eye.
But we're positive that you'll do just fine, dear. We have faith in you.
Thank you. I won't let you down.